Hi, this is Shannon with She Can Sassy Nails by Shannon. I'm going to do a full mani with using just one set. This is Deep Water Opal from the Core Catalog. As you can see, if you're new to Color Street, this is what you get in a full set. You get 16 total strips, 8 different sizes. You get a little nail file and a little prep pad. And I am going to separate my strips and pull out the ones that I'm going to use for this mani. We're going to take those two and we're going to go like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, all right. And then I'm going to take my leftovers and seal them up. So they go back in the plastic sleeve. And then I heat seal them with a flat iron. Like this. Just for a couple seconds. I did prep my nails. I clipped them and filed them. I do have the Color Street Nail Strengthener on. I am going to start with my pinky because I use my thumbs as my cutting tool. And so I take off the plastic first layer and I separate the strip from the backing. And then I actually place it back on the little paper backing that it comes with, and as long as you're putting it back on the shiny side, though there's a little glossy side, it helps. I'm gonna turn on my heating mat. I use it to kind of anchor the strip so I don't have to handle the strip as much. You don't have to do it that way. These strips are very thin and pliable. They are 100% nail polish. They come 95 to 97% dry. And I just use my thumbs just like this to clip or to kind of cut off the excess. And then sometimes I like to. So you're just going to want to push down really nicely. And then if I have a little overlap on the edge, you can take your fingernail and just peel that off so you don't need any tools. A lot of us do like to take a couple tools that we use sometimes to help us, but if we don't have these items or are on the go, you totally don't have to use them. So you want to just, like I said, you keep pushing down. You can use what's called a rubber cuticle pusher to help get that nice and smooth. If you have any little bumps or wrinkles, it helps get them adhered nicely. And then you want to make sure these cure. They usually cure after 20 to 30 minutes. I try to give it a couple hours before I would like bathe or shower. Actually, I do my mani at night a lot so I can let them cure overnight. So I take that little tab off. So then I have a double-ended strip. So you don't have to use both sides. You can if you want to or if you're careful enough. I did not center that perfectly. I think it's okay. I don't think I'll be able to get it up because I have. If I didn't have a base coat on, I could have maneuvered those a little bit differently. They would have come up off my bare nail, but because I do have a nail strengthener on the bottom, I have Color Street's nail strengthener that I like to use. Not every mani, but every once in a while. You could use it every mani if you wanted to. I have pretty strong nails, so I don't need to. I don't feel the need to. But I also take a hand, like what is it called? Skin, hair, and nail, like gummy multivitamin. I try to make sure I drink plenty of water. So the goal is to try to get that centered on your nail, as close to the base of your nail, as close to that proximal fold, that cuticle, without overlapping the skin. And then, like I said, I'm just cutting these with my thumbnail, trying to center it as well as I can. It doesn't have to be perfect. I tend to be a perfectionist, but it does not have to be perfect. And then I just kind of pick off the excess. I'm going to come back in, just make sure to smooth all these down. Again, you could take a rubber cuticle pusher. You can also take, so this is the other way, instead of using your fingernail, or if you don't have long fingernails, you can take a wood stick like this, a wood cuticle pusher, or sometimes it's called an orange stick. I'll clean up. I had to try to get that off my mat. I love the glitter in this set. Can you see? This is called Prism Effects Glitter, where it's color shifting, kind of depending on how the light hits it. It's a little bit irregular shaped glitters. So this is the clear layer that you take off first, then the silver tab, and I just turn it and place it back on here so I can handle it without touching the strip. It's useful with our clear overlays so that you don't get fingerprints on it, but it's definitely not something you have to do, especially when you're just learning. Sometimes if a strip is a little stickier than normal, that anchor technique is helpful because you can stick it on that little paper instead of it sticking to your skin. And then you can see how this strip, oh, it's kind of out of focus, hold on. How the glitter, you can see, picks up like greens and oranges. It's kind of different depending on how the light hits it, and it's on a dark blue background. Another technique you can do to clean up the edges, you can pull it over here. Instead of using your thumbnail, then you could take a rubber cuticle pusher and perforate it with that, or that orange stick. I'm just going to grab it with my fingernail though. That is what I'm used to doing. You can also file that, as long as you're filing it in like a downward or even an underneath kind of motion. You just don't want to file up or file too aggressively to wear that tip of that strip off. And then, so pull that first clear layer off. There's a little colored stripe to help, and it says peel off printed on it, so that should help. And then this one I'm going to use. Some of the strips are different widths at different ends on that double-sided strip. Sorry, hold on a second, I got a little excess here that I didn't get off. And I wanted to make sure it's not going to get stuck under my strip, because then I'd have a little bump. Okay, so I'm going to center that as close to I can on the, at the base of that nail. And then you can kind of gently pull, kind of stretch any bumps, any wrinkles out. And I kind of start at the base and you're pushing up towards the end. And then I like to over go pull, wrap that strip around the end of the fingernail and then kind of perforate it with my fingernail at the underneath, so it's wrapping around that tip of the nail. And then let's see if this is big enough. It usually isn't long enough to do my whole nail. So then I take the other one, which is why I got both of the thumbs, the two largest strips for this one. And then I will show you. Oopsie, it's a little, got it stuck to one of my other nails. So again, line it up. Oh, I didn't go all the way to the bottom of my nail. That's okay. Again, it doesn't have to be perfect. So one thing you can do is you can gather all that excess strip at the base here. And then, like I said, you can come in with a file, you can come in with a cuticle pusher and cut underneath your nail. Because if I use my thumb to clean up this last one, I could ruin the strip that I put on. So I don't want to do that. So I didn't go see, that's fine, it'll look fine. It might be harder to see on camera. I have a little space between my skin and where I applied the strip on this one, which it's not my ideal, my perfect look, but it is fine. Nobody will notice, and it's kind of what it looks like as it starts to grow out anyway. I actually have to put a new mani on in a couple days anyway. We're having a big winter party hosted by my friend Stacy called The Ruckus. All right, so let's smooth this out a little bit. Make sure they're all pushed down nicely. Let's see if there's a little bit I can trim off of this one or not. A little bit. All right. So there you have it. Nice. This is going to be a quick, short and sweet video. Color Street, a single set. Most of the time I mix and match my sets, but I have a vendor event, I wanted to showcase one set, and this is Deepwater Opal from our core catalog. Alright, have a great night or day, depending on when you watch this. I'll talk to you later. Bye bye.